Collective, welcome back. I'm super, super hype. I know I've been MIA. I actually posted a video like a few days back, maybe a week or two ago, and it never uploaded. And I literally have been so busy. I honestly haven't had time to jump back on here, but I do have some messages to the collective. You know I'm thinking about you even when I'm not on here. Trust me, I'm like, oh my God, I need to do my YouTube video. I've just been, like I said, just so busy and really pushing because you guys, I'm trying to grow this business this year. It's so important to me to really get my energy right and get right for y'all, you know? Otherwise, what the fuck am I even doing readings for if I'm not doing the work outside of these readings? So I will pull some cards today. I'm not even asking any questions and they're already wanting to come out. I will pull cards today and I want to talk over some downloads. Oh my gosh, you guys, I've been receiving some crazy downloads. First of all, an estate sale could be significant. Solo travel could be significant. Sunflowers are significant. 666, 711 is significant. 911 is significant. Vanilla is significant. clouds are significant. The sun is significant. I'm hearing Aquarius placements are significant. You may be learning a new language. You may be traveling to a foreign country, this summer. If you haven't received that news yet, it's coming. Yeah, some of you guys are going to be traveling. Some of you guys need to stop acting desperate. And some of you guys aren't acting desperate at all. Okay, praise God. We have the Empress. And my apologies, Spirit. Thank you so much for connecting me with this collective. Thank you so much for allowing me to reach through through you and be a vessel for you. Thank you for rising us up out of bed. Thank you for reminding us why we're here. Thank you for putting our feet on earth and grounding us down and keeping us moving forward. We appreciate that energy. We appreciate your knowledge, your divine intelligence that speaks to us, that sees us, that respects us, that holds us so close and dear. Thank you for loving us and putting us on the path to perfection, which is within you, Spirit. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you to the Almighty. We thank you for these messages tonight. We thank you for this connection tonight. We thank you for allowing this to reach the collective that it needs to reach tonight, God. Ooh, we're just in so, so, so much gratitude for you, God. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, okay? In your mighty name we pray, amen. Okay, that's the thing. Wow, some of you have really given it to God. You've just given it to God. That's why you're in your Empress energy, because you've really said, like, I'm no longer doing this alone. And I really feel like I feel like that was the last message actually that was posted. It was like, let God handle it. And that's what you did. You finally gave it to God because you realized it was too heavy to carry. You realized it was too much of a burden. You were sick of waking up in sadness and in fear every day. We have the Knight of Cups next to the Empress, and then we have the Knight of Swords, okay? You've literally given your sword to God. You said, God, can you help me fight this battle? I can't do it without you. The Bhagavad Gita is coming through right now. This is an important book that you should actually tap into because there's a message in there for you, okay? You are riding into your new life because of the surrender. The surrender created more space for you to actually receive what it is that you were asking for. And this could be something that's from a past life. This could be something that's from your childhood. But that surrender has made some space. And it is now cultivating a sense of stability, I'm hearing. Actually, you really started doing this in Taurus season. What you did in Taurus season actually opened up a sense of... It opened up space, okay? Like that big grass field that you drive by when you're on the expressway. Like, you look over and you just see all that space, and there's nothing that's occupying it. Like, that's now the space that has been made within you, and it's beautiful, and it's comfortable, and it gives you room to, like, actually create now. Like, this is why I really like when people say, like, they're creating. They just go in and they just do it. They just start doing things, and they're not really caring about what the end result is. They're getting curious, and I feel like that's where you're at now. We have the Three of Pentacles and the Eight of Cups in reverse, and that's what I feel. It's like you don't really have, like, an authorized plan. It's just like you're going in through your intuition, and it's like you're not looking for success, you're not looking for victory, you're not looking for anything. Like, you're just out of that energy of competition, and you're in more of an energy of, like, what's for me won't pass me by, and I don't have to go out and look for it. I don't have to go out and, like, fuck around and find out anymore. Like, it's kind of like a lot of y'all are just done self-sabotaging. You don't want to self-sabotage anymore because you're realizing how much consequences you paid, how much time you've served doing dumb shit. Yeah, the Queen of Cups, okay? You were in, like, an energy where you felt like you needed to prove yourself. And now you're in an energy where it's almost as things are flowing so easily to you because you're no longer allowing yourself to be judged. You're no longer, like, allowing yourself to be the victim. You're no longer allowing yourself to feel like an outcast. Like, you are the center point, the access point of love. And this love is what ultimately has opened you up to your truth, to what is for you. Like, you've now opened up this, like, massive, it's like a massive, like, blockage that you've kind of shifted and curdled out of the way so you can now receive the love that you've been looking for. You've been doing things alone now. You've been driving around listening to some of your favorite songs. You just made a new playlist. Like, you're just enjoying the little things, you know? And that is some serious energy. Death to the old you. Like, you don't even know where you're going. It's like you, bitch, got your fucking blink around, bitch. It says it's left, and then you turn right. And, like, you just don't even realize. Like, you're, like, actually becoming the you that you were when you were a kid before the world told you who you were supposed to be. Like, there's just so much that was weighing you down that you've released. And I'm, like, so happy I'm hearing Capricorn. So this could have been around the Capricorn full moon. It could have been, you could have Capricorn placements. You could even have Scorpio placements, but you could have had a death that just happened in your life that made you say, I'm not going to live like this anymore. I'm not going to hold myself back anymore. I deserve peace and I deserve love. And so now you are giving yourself the peace, that you simply just couldn't have before because you weren't willing to die for it. Just show the city what it takes to be alive for it, okay? Eight of Pentacles, yes. I'm telling you, some of you are going to be successful. Nine of Swords, like, you're literally able to sleep better at night. You're able to kind of see into the future. Like, you're having more psychic vision. You're feeling the path out. Like, you're just trusting in the divine. Like, you're sleeping because you're no longer stressed. You're like, oh, God's got it. Like, I don't even have to worry about my rent. God's paying it. Like, I don't have to worry about, you know, yeah, judgment. What the fuck did I say? You don't give a fuck about judgment anymore. Like, you're like, I know myself. Like, at the end of the day, I'm not judging myself for where I've been, because where I'm going is a very different tale than what I've been told, what I've lived. Your story is changing. Your story has changed. You have changed. You are confident now. You are not afraid of holding yourself accountable anymore. Like, even if you make a mistake, you're quick to say, hey, I actually made that mistake, and I'm going to own up to it. And it's like, as soon as you do, you're met with so much peace and serenity. It's like, you just don't have the space anymore energetically to lie. You don't have the space energetically anymore to self-sabotage. You don't have the space anymore to hold back. Like, you are flowing and you're being vulnerable and you're releasing these parts that have felt so brittled and felt so fucking just like rigid. Like, you're no longer rigid. You're just like happy. Like, you're just free flowing. You're just enamored with like life right now. Like, yeah, I don't know, baby. It's like, it's just giving. Like, these last few months, like, you've like had like little milestones, but then you've also feel like the door has been slammed in your face a bit, but at the same time it's like helped you pivot. Like, you're just like, okay, I'll do this instead. Like, you're no longer getting stuck in one spot. Like, the stagnancy has even cleared. Like, you're like, whatever, I'm just gonna go this way now. Like, I'm not feeling this anymore. Like, you're not afraid to leave jobs. Like, you're not afraid to leave relationships. Like, you're making better decisions for yourself. It's like, it's a new self-love era. Ooh, Libra could be significant as well.
Manifestation.
Yeah, see, your manifestation is coming in, you guys. Like I said, that space that you made, look at the clouds on there. Look at the clouds, you guys. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Go on Instagram _ KATLYNMOSS. Go look at my channeled messages, okay? First of all, we have a 9, which is like the ending of a cycle, but I put on there the rain. I said rain is a good thing. Oh, my God. Because why? Rain is like you're... It's raining, man. Hallelujah. It's raining, man. Amen. Oh, my God.
Worthiness.
Okay, you're feeling worthy now. Like, your manifestations are coming because you feel worthy. I believe these are lilies. Have I not been channeling fucking lilies for the last 3 months? Everybody who fucking sleeps on me, fuck you. Okay, 14, that's a 5. 5 is the number of change. It's the number of manifestation because change creates manifestations. Like, it's creating the inertia for it to happen. Look at these cups pouring on their own. Like, you're just being, like, you're being poured into because you've poured into yourself. The transformation that's coming is actually a transformation out of worry and fear and scarcity and kind of low vibrational energy and into a more lightness, Piscean belief, expansion, passion, compassion, nurture energy. Like, you don't have to worry about things being taken care of because you just are taken care of because you're the child of the divine. I literally feel like there's mosquitoes biting me. It sucks, you guys, because I really feel like the reason I don't do these videos more often is because I don't have a lot of time alone. But that's gonna change. But yeah, like, when I'm alone, I can really get into the word. You know what I mean? When people are around, I'd be like,
I'm trying to give a message
right now. I need you to leave. Like, I literally cannot have people in the room. Another 5 here. Look at that, baby. So much change. New beginnings coming in. Radical rebirth, okay? Look at the lions on there. Leo energy could be prominent in your chart. You could have a Leo stellium, I'm hearing. Leo Venus. Leo Mars. Mars is in Leo right now, too. Like, you, I swear, and I just did a reading on this. We are literally changing through our ability to express from a healthy and vulnerable space, by telling our truth, by shining a light in the void on places that we don't really like to go visit in our minds, that we're afraid of. We're letting go of the fraudulent beliefs of ourselves. We're going after our desires despite our fears. Okay. yeah, like, there's, like, a lot of you have some dreams to do things that are not necessarily conventional, and spirit is saying, if you just go after it, I promise, like, wherever you land, I'll catch you, okay? Like, you're not gonna fall. Like, I'm literally asking you to take this leap of faith.
Dog scratch confirmation. Can you see this dog in the background? Like I said,
That's an 8 too. This is, once again, Leo energy. It could also mean the 8th house, so Scorpio placements. Like, some of you guys are just quantum leaping heavily, and it's because of the choices that you're making and decisions around why you are making the choices that you are making. Like, it's, there's more intention now, and you're doing it from a space of, like, this is a quote I heard. It's like, there's a ton of other people who are doing it shittier than you can. Put your fucking shit out there. Like, that's not how the quote goes. I freestyled. But put your shit out there. Like, take the leap. Trust that what you know is enough. And if you don't know, you will be met with a teacher on your path who will help you expand further into your studies. Just, like, put yourself out there and keep creating and keep making. Like, keep trying. If you have a dream, just try it. What you start with is not going to be what you end with. What you end with is going to be way better. So it's like, just start doing it. Like, start making those videos. Like, learn how to edit. Like, people want to see your life. I really feel like you taking this leap is going to just bring you so much abundance in friendship and in family and support and finances. Yeah, harvest. You're literally about to reap what you sow. Look at her dancing once again. Like, baby, that's a 7 too. Like, good luck, good fortune. July is going to be significant for you. It's going to be a really beautiful time of just, like, feeling free, liberation, 10. Like, all the new beginnings are coming through for you. And you're over here, like, worried, biting your fingernails. Like, oh my God. Does God love me? Does God love me? Of course. The fuck do you mean? God's obsessed with you. God is literally obsessed with you. I know God's obsessed with me. That's, I really, like, damn, God, another message? You just gave me one. Oh my God. Okay, this part went all the way. Yeah, I'm flexible as fuck. 3, inspiration. You're being inspired again, okay? 3 is also, like, it's giving the womb, okay? It's giving the sacral. You are creating from a space of inspiration now. Like, you guys, I'm telling you, I just created these rugs and I, like, didn't even think about doing what I did with the mirrors. And then, like, I did the mirrors. Like, I put these, like, healing stones around them. And I was like, oh my God, I've never seen anyone create this. But I just followed my, like, intuition, and I just made it, and, like, it's so cool, and now I'm, like, getting all these other ideas of what I could do, and it's, like, wow, like, this is just all I've ever wanted to do, is, like, create from the space of not knowing, but being able to just see it and try it and see if it works, you know? And so, like, that's what spirit is saying. There could be bees around you. Once again, we're seeing lilies here. Like, your ancestors are very much communicating with you in speaking through you. My candle's starting to flicker a little bit, okay? Like, trust it. Trust the journey. Where you are is, like, you guys don't even get it. Like, this is just the beginning. You're coming back to life. 7. The color in your face is coming back to life. Like, your skin just looks clearer. Like, you're glowing. Like I said, you could have heavy Leo placements. 45, Pandora's gift. We have another 9 here. Like, I used to be terrified of 9s because I just had a really bad experience with 9. But, like, 9 sets you up for the new beginning, okay? So we're all kind of in the 9 energy right now, like that 9-month cycle. We're very pregnant. We want this baby to just fucking drop out of us and let us be back in our bodies again. And, like, that is what is happening. Like, this next month is expansion. I don't know why June just reminds me so much of the sign Ju or the asteroid Juno, but Juno is literally the birth of like the baby. It's like the expansion that comes from the connection, the sacred energy exchange between source, you and your divine partner. And sometimes it doesn't necessarily have to be the divine partner. Like June just represents the expression being expanded. You're like a baby is an expression of love, right? So like you are, whatever you are expressing will be expanded this season, and it could just be self-exploration, it could be exploration in sex, it could be exploration in art, it could be exploration in books, whatever it is, it's expanding you, it's giving you more knowledge, it's giving you a new way of being, it's giving you a new path. So like accept what spirit is giving you. Just say yes, baby. Say yes, baby. I don't know who that was for, because that was kind of dirty, but I just felt like that was like coming through softly, softly, the tender touch. Okay, someone's about to be touching you so tenderly. Like, also, I've been channeling Lotus energy. Like, you're coming from like under the murky waters and merging, and it's like this beautiful siren goddess that's just like staring through your soul, and she just sees you, and you're like, you see me? You motherfucking see me, bitch? You get all fucking teary-eyed and shit, looking like a motherfucking pussy, and everybody's like, baby, we see you. Two, yeah, like I feel like this is some relationship energy. Okay, I'm into the relationship stuff, spirit. What's coming in this relationship? This summer, everyone's gonna be, okay, your friends that were celibate are gonna be hoes again. Some of you guys. Some of you are gonna be in a serious like thing with someone. Some of you for real are about to be like in a really serious relationship soon. And it's funny because you're like, with who? Inner trust. Like, come on, get out of here. Two. That's two twos, you guys, which is a four, which is all about the home, building a foundation. Some of you are really like this whole energy has all been about inner trust and how you've like established that within yourself. And this is bringing you into a relationship with a partner who has established that same need, that same want, that same work has been established within him, and that is bringing you guys together. Beyond the mind, the heart beats. That's a three, okay? We have two and a three there. Yeah, this is a divine connection. This is actually being put together by your ancestors. This is obviously for a specific group, and it really depends on if you've been doing the work. But like I said, we started this reading with an Empress energy. That Empress energy is now receiving from what work she's put in, okay? She started her path with one, okay? She met her partner with two, okay? She understood the assignment that spirit had given them both with three. Okay, spirit is our third, is our three. I'm feeling super called to pull from this deck, and whoever you are a very lucky individual, and I want you to start thinking that way. This card is at the bottom of the deck here, and it's like staring at me, but the sunflower is really standing out to me as well as the music. Okay, this person could be a sound engineer or someone who is working in music. Summer is obviously very significant. It says Shaka the New, and so this could be like. Didn't I say someone was going solo traveling or like something? You may be going to like a concert or something and you meet this person. This person could be like playing at the concert and sees you and pulls you over. This could be someone who actually DMs you who's a musician or something, just is like, hey, I found your page and I just think you're really cool. Would you want to come backstage and hang out with me? Like, this is the kind of energy I'm getting. Spirit said, close your legs. So, just because someone gives you attention doesn't necessarily mean you gotta feed into that whole thing. Like, the Empress, you know, she knows her worth. So, just make sure that when someone approaches you, that you're not like, oh my God, you want my number? Like, bitch, no. What's up? Well, I'm actually looking for a serious relationship. Yeah, that's something that I've, decided that I wanted recently, and it's what, I'm doing moving forward in my dating life. Talk like you understand the assignment, like you know what you want, because you do. So assume that anybody that's coming in your vibrational field is going to test that energy to make sure that you are standing on what it is that you say you want and that you need. The relics of Lemuria, that's a five. Okay, we've had a lot of fives in this reading, so you better believe this is all coming from a space of change. We're having those nodes switch out of Scorpio and Taurus, moving into Aries and Libra in July. Like I said, we're gonna see a lot of change happening in June as we expand, but once we get into July, we're really gonna start seeing some of the changes that we started making in January of last year, okay? Like, or this year. It feels like last year. I don't even remember January, to be honest. But like, that's really what's happening. Like, everything is happening through choice right now. White birds could be significant. Memories are coming up. Allow them to be seen, to be felt. Hold them dear into your heart, but then release them. The past is really not the future, babies. It's not. It has clues into integration of your future, but it's not your future, and you just gotta let some things go so you can really expand into who you were meant to be. The secret unknown and Tree of Souls, collective wisdom. Okay, we're all in this together. We're all actually going through a lot of the same things right now, and so I want you to really lean on your community because your community is what actually knows you because you are experiencing your community through your own vessel, okay? 33, the gathering. Once again, this is about community. This is like who you come in partnership with is literally, you guys will start a community. Companionship, yeah. It's giving, like, I don't want to be repetitive. I feel already very connected to this message. I feel like this is a message for me as much as it is for you. But what we are overcoming and what we are doing right now is way bigger than, some petty bills and shit, okay? So stop stressing about the little things and get prepared for the big things because spirit is bringing in an abundance of change in your life, and this is the time to really just get clear and get ready and get excited because it's just nothing is going to be the same. Like, nothing is. And if you're not in a good headspace, you're only going to manifest the opposite of what we're all manifesting, which is change, which is growth, which is evolution. So be prepared to change and be prepared for what it is that you ask for, because spirit is very serious about his children. And what has been done to us in the past, baby, is not going unnoticed. It actually never went unnoticed. Spirit was really just giving people a second chance to act right, baby, and what they never act right. Now I gotta play this song because this actually came up. I mean, it has. It actually came up today, though, when I was driving, and it really put me in the motherfucking mood because I have been back and forth in my head about a lot of shit. But this motherfucking song got me to fucking act right, okay? And you know it's about to be Yo Gotti.
Got them bottles on replay. What? Tryna break a record like a DJ. There's 150 bottles in one night. I get it, bitch. Act right. Act right. Act right. Money don't fold, is that act right? Act right. Act right. Nigga playing games, get that act right. Going. Back to the bay. Rest in peace, man. Right. On the screen, nigga, all I do is talk, yeah. Want me in your city, nigga, know they gon' pay. I ain't looking for a free though.
Y'all need to start acting right.
Trying to break a record like a DJ. That's 150 balls in.
right. You know when you're in the club? I haven't been in the club in so long. I need to go. I feel like this song needs to make a comeback. I wish they made music like this again. One day it's gonna get me in the car acting crazy and just have me the crank gun. Okay. Anyways, y'all better start acting right. That's enough. Okay, the iPad be going crazy. Y'all know that that's my sidekick right there. But anyways, get ready to act right this summer. Okay, Leo energy does not play. It is fun. It is vibrant. It is alive. You are going to be so alive this summer. You are going to be so alive this June especially. And we have a lot of energy moving through Leo all fucking summer long. So just get prepared to enjoy your life, to enjoy what's to come, and just to enjoy the present moment. Don't get caught up in storylines. Don't get caught up in past, you know, shit. Get caught up in the now. And watch all the expansion that comes through to you when you act from your heart and not from your motherfucking head. I love you. Cheers. Hopefully this one uploads.